Winter Haven, Florida. Winter Haven is a city in Polk County, Florida, United States. It is 51 miles east of Tampa. The population was 33,874 at the 2010 census. According to the U.S. Census Bureau's 2015 estimates, the city had a population of 37,689, making it the second most populated city in Polk County. It is a principal city of the Lakeland-Winter Haven, Florida Metropolitan Statistical Area. The Timucua and the Calusa were the earliest known inhabitants of the land that would become Winter Haven. Both of these groups were deeply impacted by war and disease from the Spanish conquest of Florida in the early 1500s. The Timucua were particularly affected by the expedition of Hernando de Soto. By the 19th century, both these groups no longer existed. During these expeditions, the Spanish explorers claimed the entire peninsula of Florida for the Spanish monarchy. In the 19th century, the Creek and the Seminole were known to live and hunt in this area. During the Seminole Wars, the Seminole leader, Chipco, and his followers were known to live in the Winter Haven area. Several small skirmishes during the war were fought in and around Winter Haven. In 1819, after the signing of the Adams-Onis Treaty, the United States gained control of Florida. The first American or European settlers in the area were encouraged to settle here by the Armed Occupation Act of 1842. During the 1840s and 1850s, the United States government conducted the first surveys of the area. Henry Washington conducted the first survey of the area in 1843. In 1849, Dr. John Westcott completed an extensive survey of the area, including mapping many of the local lakes. The first maps of the area were published by the United States government in 1854. In 1883, Colonel Henry Haynes, working for Henry Plant and the Plant System, successfully built the first railroad across Polk County, passing just north of Winter Haven. Lake Haynes, in Winter Haven, was named after Colonel Haynes. The arrival of the railroad created the first real growth in area. The area was platted in 1884 and would first be known as Harris Corners. This name was in reference to F.A.K. Harris, who opened the first mercantile store in the area around this time. The name Winter Haven was later suggested, in reference to the area's pleasant climate. By the end of the century, the population grew to approximately 400, and in 1911, the city of Winter Haven was incorporated. The chain of lakes canals were begun in 1915. The first Florida boom took place in the 1920s as towns sprang up all over the peninsula. Florida's potential as a place to live and a place to visit was first realized in the 1920s, but the Great Depression slowed growth until after World War II. Winter Haven Hospital was founded in 1926 and has been in the city ever since. During this period, the population of Winter Haven began to grow substantially. Many beautiful single-family homes were built in Winter Haven at this time in the Colonial Revival style. Over 50 of these homes are on the National Register of Historic Places today. They are noted for their architectural style and grace. Most of these historic homes are located in the Interlochen neighborhood. There are four historic districts in Winter Haven. They are Interlochen, Pope Avenue, Winter Haven Heights, and the downtown area. In 1930, George W. Jenkins opened the first Publix supermarket in Winter Haven. His second store and the first standalone Publix store was a 27 feet by 65 feet building at 199 West Central Avenue, opened in 1935, which exists today as the Regeneration's Thrift Store. During the 1930s and 1940s, citrus magnate John A. Snively operated one of the largest fruit packing plants in the world in Winter Haven. Another defining event in Winter Haven was the opening of Cypress Gardens in 1936 by Dick Pope, Sr. and his wife, Julie Pope. They first got the idea for the park from a Good Housekeeping magazine that they were reading. By the 1950s, Cypress Gardens was nationally famous. It featured a beautiful botanical garden, water skiing shows, and a staff of Southern Belles. Many famous celebrities of that time visited the park, including Elvis Presley, Frank Sinatra, Betty Grable, and King Hussein of Jordan. In the 1980s, the Anheuser-Busch Corporation purchased the park. They continued to operate the park until 1995. After that, the park struggled, finally closing for good in 2009. On January 21, 2010, the site of Cypress Gardens was formally announced as the selected location for Legoland Florida, which opened on October 15, 2011. Legoland Florida is a state-of-the-art, world-class theme park that successfully retains some of the tradition and history of the original site, including part of the original botanical garden and a water ski show. Winter Haven featured many buildings designed by Jean Leedy, one of the founders of the Sarasota School of Architecture. Regency Medical Center, which is Winter Haven Hospital's women's hospital, was built in 1987. The Orange Dome, located near the corner of Cypress Gardens Boulevard and U.S. Highway 17, was built in 1964. For 48 years, it hosted the annual Citrus Festival and other civic affairs. In February 2012, the Orange Dome was demolished to make way for The Landings, a proposed $150 million mixed-use development that was intended to include high-end retail stores, restaurants, hotels, apartments and a new movie theater to be built at the Chain of Lakes complex. However, after the construction of three fast food chain stores, the project collapsed. Currently, the developer and the city are in negotiations to determine the future of the site. Pusseville was a neighborhood of Winter Haven where African Americans built a community after the Civil War. A historical marker on Highway 17 at Avenue O commemorates the community. According to the marker, Pusseville was one of Winter Haven's earliest neighborhoods and was settled by African Americans who cleared the land in the southwest section of the city. Pusseville was named for an early black pioneer, Reverend Charles Pugh, who was a founder of one of Zion Hill Missionary Baptist Church. Pusseville was also home to Bethel AME, St. Paul Holiness, and Church of Christ. The community was most active from the 1900s until the 1950s and had an African American school, social halls, small grocery stores, and restaurants where some residents worked. Others worked in the citrus industry or in state or federal jobs. Pusseville produced Winter Haven's first African American commissioner, medical doctor, mayor, firefighter and postal worker. The community declined in the late 1970s as larger commercial establishments began arriving in the area. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of 25.4 square miles, of which 17.7 square miles is land and 7.7 square miles is water. Winter Haven is located within the Central Florida Highlands area of the Atlantic Coastal Plain with a terrain consisting of flatland interspersed with gently rolling hills. It has an average elevation of 146 feet above sea level. The city is located at the headwaters of the Peace River. Winter Haven has 50 lakes within its borders, including its famous chain of lakes. The lakes are by far the city's most distinctive feature. Winter Haven bills itself as the Chain of Lake City. The city has two prominent chains of lakes. The northern chain has 9 lakes interconnected by a series of canals. The southern chain features 16 lakes interconnected by a series of canals. The southern chain has several prominent lakes, including Lake Eloise, Lake Howard, and Lake Lulu. In 2011, after 6 years of construction and political infighting, Winter Haven opened a canal lock system connecting the two chains. Most of the lakes in Winter Haven formed in a similar fashion to sinkholes, through dissolving of the limestone ground. These types of lakes are called solution lakes. The lakes in Winter Haven teem with life, including alligators, bald eagles, great blue herons, and more. The Winter Haven lakes are a world-renowned spot for bass fishing. Winter Haven is located in the humid subtropical zone. The city gets its name from its comparative lack of colder weather. The average temperature is 73.2 degrees Fahrenheit. The city averages 50.3 inches of rain per year. The summer months of June, July, August, and September, which includes the height of the Atlantic hurricane season, are by far the rainiest time of the year. Those 4 months, which average 29.7 inches of rain per year, account for more than half of the annual rainfall. Winters in Winter Haven are dry and sunny, with mild temperatures with highs of 70 to 73 degrees Fahrenheit and lows of 50 to 53 degrees Fahrenheit. Frosts occur on 1 or 2 nights per year on average. As of the 2010 census, Winter Haven was 55.6% white, 28.2% black, 12.5% Hispanic, 2.5% Asian. As of the census of 2000, there were 26,487 people, 11,833 households, and 6,934 families residing in the city. The population density was 1,498.3 inhabitants per square mile. There were 13,912 housing units at an average density of 787.0 per square mile. There were 11,833 households, out of which 21.6% had children under the age of 18 living with him, 42.1% were married couples living together, 12.8% had a female householder with no husband present, and 41.4% were non-families. 36.0% of all households were made up of individuals and 18.9% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.17 and the average family size was 2.81. In the city, the population was spread out with 20.9% under the age of 18, 6.8% from 18 to 24, 23.5% from 25 to 44, 21.4% from 45 to 64, and 27.4% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 44 years. For every 100 females, there were 85.1 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 81.2 males. The median income for a household in the city was $31,884, and the median income for a family was $39,657. Males had a median income of $30,943 versus $21,812 for females. The per capita income for the city was $20,383. About 10.5% of families and 15.0% of the population were below the poverty line, including 24.2% of those under age 18 and 7.9% of those age 65 or over. Three-time Olympic gold medal swimmer, Rowdy Gaines, and Olympic gold medal sprinter, Kenneth Broken Burr both grew up in Winter Haven. Four-time NBA All-Star and Olympic gold medalist guard, Otis Birdsong, also grew up in Winter Haven. Welterweight boxing champion, Andre Berto, is another famous athlete who grew up in Winter Haven. Winter Haven has many successful sports programs, both recreational and competitive, serving the youth and the community. Winter Haven High School has won several state and district championships in various sports, including girls varsity basketball state championship in 2005, 2007, 2016, and 2017. With so many lakes, Winter Haven is a location for freshwater fishing. The two sports for which Winter Haven is best known are water skiing and baseball. Winter Haven has played a major role in the development and growth of water skiing as a sport. Dick Pope, Sr. used water skiing as a way to promote his Cypress Gardens theme park starting in the 1930s, and water ski shows soon became a staple of entertainment at the park. He was also the first person to complete a jump on water skis, jumping over a wooden ramp in 1928, for a distance of 25 feet. He pioneered a number of other water skiing tricks, including the water ski human pyramid, as part of an effort to develop his shows at Cypress Gardens. His son, Dick Pope Jr. popularized barefoot water skiing. Winter Haven is connected to 10 members of the Water Ski Hall of Fame, more than any other city in the world. These include Dick Pope, Sr., Dick Pope Jr., and Ricky McCormick. George A. Banana George Blair, who still holds several water ski world records, was first introduced to the sport while visiting Winter Haven in the 1950s. Winter Haven has many lakes, including its famous chain of lakes, that are perfect for water skiing. Today, several successful ski schools, for both water skiing and barefoot skiing, make their home there. Every day, all year round, water skiers can be seen practicing their sport on the lakes around town. Winter Haven was a Major League Baseball spring training site for many years, first at Denison Stadium and later at Chain of Lakes Park. Many of the greatest baseball players in history played in Florida's spring training Grapefruit League, and passed through Winter Haven to play games, including Jimmy Fox, Lou Gehrig, Willie Mays, Roberto Clemente, Johnny Bench, and Hank Aaron. In 1928, the Philadelphia Phillies were the first Major League Baseball team to call Winter Haven their spring home. The Phillies built Denison Stadium, which featured a large, covered wooden grandstand. The Phillies played spring training games there until 1938. In 1940, the New York Giants did one season there. After baseball left Denison Stadium, the facility was donated to the city for the benefit youth athletics. The stadium, with a modernized grandstand, is still in use today, frequently hosting football, soccer, track and field, and other events. In 1966, the Boston Red Sox and spring training baseball returned to Winter Haven. The Red Sox played in the newly built Chain of Lakes Park, a state-of-the-art facility at that time. For 26 years, the Red Sox called Winter Haven their spring home. When the Red Sox left in 1992 to move to Fort Myers, Florida, the city of Winter Haven was looking to attract another Major League Baseball team. Later that year, Hurricane Andrew devastated Homestead, Florida, including the spring training facilities of the Cleveland Indians. The Indians were in search of a new spring home, and they were a perfect match for Winter Haven. The Indians played 16 seasons at Chain of Lakes Park, leaving in 2008. In 2008, after failed negotiations with the city to renovate Chain of Lakes Park, the Indians moved into a brand new stadium in Goodyear, Arizona. Chain of Lakes Park today hosts Russ Matt Collegiate Baseball Tournament. The stadium was slated for demolition and redevelopment into a shopping center, called The Landings, but those plans are currently stalled. Public schools in Winter Haven are operated by Polk County Public Schools. Winter Haven is part of the Tampa/St. Pete television market, the 13th largest in the country and part of the local Lakeland/Winter Haven radio market, which is the 94th largest in the country. Since 1911, the Winter Haven News Chief has served the community as the local newspaper. The News Chief also published the Polk County Shopper and ran the site polkonline.com. In 2008, News Chief was taken over by the Lakeland Ledger and operations were merged into that paper's Winter Haven branch. Major routes through, to, and from Winter Haven include: the streets of downtown Winter Haven are arranged in a grid plan. First Street is the north-south axis, with two sets of numbered streets running parallel, one to the east, and one to the west. Central Avenue is the west-east axis, with two sets of lettered avenues similarly running parallel on either side. Local commuter bus service is provided by Winter Haven Area Transit and the Citrus Connection. Winter Haven's Gilbert Airport and the adjacent Jack Brown Seaplane Base are located 3 miles northwest of the Central Business District. Winter Haven has an Amtrak train station served by the Silver Star and Silver Meteor. Station served by the Silver Star and Silver Meteor. Station served by the Silver Star and